DRQ exclusive.
Good evening, America. What's poppin'? How you doing? You already tuning in to the Blaze Experience Show. What's up? Got my Hannah Montana glove on. Hey, do the Michael Jackson with me. Holy shit. I got something to show y'all. You already know I got something to show you guys. Hold on. We gotta unravel. Can I get a drum beat, please? You know I gotta sit here and show off my sexiness and shit like that. You know I gotta show that shit off, man. How you doing? What's poppin', America? How we doing tonight? How we doing on this Friday evening? I know y'all bitches ain't getting drunk right now. Why? Because you was waiting for me to pop up with another Blaze Experience Show. You already know. Wow. I know y'all probably gonna sit here and be like, this crazy motherfucker. I know he did not just have NSYNC playing on his intro show. Yes, okay, I like NSYNC. NSYNC, they're alright, you know. Justin Timberlake, yes, you might be fine as hell, but you need the boys back, because you should. No, alright. Instead of doing these solo careers, you need to say bye to the solo careers and say hi. To the whole group shit again, because of the fact that it's a recession, bitch. Everybody needs money. And as far as tonight's episode, we about to really show how much everybody needs money, because there's been quite an amount of injustice that has just been going on, and I don't understand how the fuck that this bullshit has been, you know, commenced and has been allowed to go on. But excuse me, I have to take a drink. You already know. I would not be black if I did not sit here and have some motherfucking high. What is this? Hawaiian Punch? And we got the Greenberry Rush going on. Hey! Loaded with the vitamin C. Before we kick off tonight's show, I want to give a shout out. See, I remember the name of the store, Tony, so don't worry, I got you. Want to give a shout out to my boy Tony out in Tarrytown doing his own thing. Big ups to him. You know, go check him out, you guys. He's the manager at RC Dollar. Go up in there. We got a lot of fucking shit that's going on up in there. You know, next time I come down to Westchester, you know I'm going to come check you out. I might have you on a goddamn show. You never know, because you know I do something crazy. As long as I got my baby with me, my motherfucking laptop, my little mini shit. All right? Because as you've seen over the past few weeks, I had my crazy-ass nutty friends up on here taking over the fucking show and all that shit. You guys were loving it. You were loving it, America. And I was loving this shit, too, even though I was under the table. Let me also give a shout-out to my cousin, Lisa. What's going on, bro? How you doing? Hey! Let me give a shout-out to all my haters out there. I'm still doing me. I'm still kicking it. We going on how many months now? It's been since September, October, so that's... I failed math, guys. You gotta bear with me. Like 4 or 5 months, we sitting here still running strong. I might not be like everybody else and have 1,000 plays yet, but, bitch, I'm pretty up there, you know, especially for just starting this shit, you know. I got a lot of support and a lot of, you know, love from everybody. I got a lot of hate from everybody. Still get hate mail, still get fan mail, but you know what? What can you do? Next thing you know, I'm gonna have paparazzi knocking on my motherfucking door, looking at me in my window, like, maybe I should close these shades, because living up here in the woods, you never know who's watching you. Never know who's watching you. But, anywho, so, okay, I got a story for you guys. Now tell me if this shit does not deserve to be on Ripley's Believe It or Not. So, before I even go on, no, we're not going to get into interruptions tonight because of the fact that my cell phone is gone, and I'm pretty upset about the shit. At least the bitch is paid for right now. I already paid off my fucking bills, so I just got to cut the service, be like, bitch, my phone bill is paid, so there's no reason for you motherfuckers to try and cut my service. And yes, this has to do with the story tonight, because it really bothered me. You know, I'm on the phone with my friend earlier today, and, you know, she was really upset. She was sitting here, you know, she was telling me how she woke up this morning, you know, as usual, went to go to work and stuff like that, and her car was missing. Like, what? How's your car missing? What the fuck? Look, you had the keys on you, right, Mom? You had the keys. Yeah, she had the keys. The keys were sitting in her hand, and she was getting ready to go to work. She already dropped the kids off and stuff like that. As you saw, her son was already featured in the last video. You know, that was him in the book. That was my nigga Dario. Every time he sees me, he always shout me out. You know, I'm going to have him on the show one day, too. I'm going to have her other son on the show, maybe her, too. You know, I got love for y'all like that. So, you know you got to be up on this craziness because everybody got to experience it. But let me ask you, America, have you experienced some shit like this? Shut up, I'm getting to the point. Yeah, so she tells me how she wakes up and she's all ready to go to work and stuff like that. You know, granted, her job is right around the corner, you know, but she needs the car to, you know, go from place to place. And she tells me how her car is missing. And I was like, what? How in the blue fuck is your car missing, girl? That don't make no goddamn sense. You know, your shit was locked up the night before, wasn't it? Yeah. So, how is the shit missing? So, she calls police and stuff like that. This bitch comes to tell me that the shit has been repossessed. Like, what? Repo? Where did the repo man come from? Because the last time I saw that movie, I was just shitting motherfucking bricks. Niggas was taking eyes back and brains and hearts. And I was like, did y'all see that movie, America? Because that shit was disgusting. It was fucking disgusting. It made my stomach turn. Like, who in the fuck in their wrong sick psycho mind would make a movie like that? But anyway, yeah, so she sits here and she tells me, you know, that apparently the bank took the car. And I'm like, well, how did the bank take the car if you don't have a loan with them? Or some shit like that. She's like, I don't fucking know, but apparently these motherfuckers turned around and made some kind of fucking account for her without her approval, shit like that, you know, and the money that she was taking for her car note to pay off and taking for her insurance, they wound up taking this money the last few months and they put it in his fucking account. So it's just like, did you have any knowledge of this shit? And she was like, no. She was like, I've been paying my fucking car insurance and my car note for the last fucking 3 years. So I don't understand where the hell did they get the you know, okay to just turn around and take it. Like, you weren't late, you were on time, you made the full amount that they asked you to pay for. So how did they call themselves just taking the car? Like, I didn't know what to say today, America. I mean, I felt really bad for her. You know, because like I said, she has two kids and, you know, she does the right thing. You know, she's working. She's not involved in the nonsense. And it's just like, I don't understand that. Where is the justice? Like, you have people day in, day out in this world that are sitting here working, busting their ass, trying to make that dollar, trying to do the right thing, trying to do this, trying to do that. And you turn around and you fuck them? Like, what about the corrupt motherfuckers that's sitting here fucking us over? Why don't you go look at them? They're not the ones making up this economy right now. It's the middle and the low. It's the entire middle class. We're all in the middle class, America. All of us. And we're the ones that's sitting here making this world go around. We're the ones that's sitting here putting food in their fucking pockets. But yet they want to sit here and tax us all types of outrageous prices for everything. Don't you know to rent a car, tax on the fucking... to rent the car is 20% interest, and that's just where I live. And my jaw hit the floor. I was like, what? Oh yeah, it's $30 a day to rent the car, but you have to pay like an extra $200 or something like that. Like, Are you serious? People these days just do anything to make a fucking quick buck. Like, damn. For all this, everybody might as well just... No, let me not say that, because we're all positive. I'm not even going to say that, America. We don't want y'all, you know, doing stupid shit, and then you get locked up. But it's just like, you know, honestly, I don't think that that's fair, because something doesn't seem right with that. How do you turn around and take somebody's car, somebody's vehicle that they're paying for, that's, you know, that's a few thousand dollars from being paid for and stuff like that? She has her own insurance. You set her up with insurance. Dude, you guys do the bank, and she doesn't need it. And then in order for her to get her car back, not only does she have to pay $1,000, but she has to prove that she has insurance, and she has to prove all this other extra shit. And it's just like, really? Like, she's been paying this shit for 3 fucking years, and you're going to do this to her? Like, I don't get that. Like, when I get my car, I'm not dealing with no banks, first and foremost. Hell no. We're dealing with straight cash, because banks, fuck y'all. Okay, because a lot of the banks out there, they're on some fucking bullshit. Like, I still get fucking, I get calls from them from how many years ago talking about an account that I already paid for. I get phone calls talking about, oh, well, you have this car insurance that you have to pay for, you know, and then that you got a ticket. How the hell do I have a goddamn car insurance that I'm paying for, and how do I have a ticket? Can we say it fraud? Identity theft? Like, I got a car, I'm still hoofing it back and forth from work walking. Hello, I got hit by a snowplow while walking. I still gotta prove that I have an injury. I mean, you know, America, 2 shows ago, you saw the injury, and my arm is still bruised and everything else. Like, I have police records, I have hospital records, I even have my prescription and stuff just chilling in my room. And I have to prove that I was injured in order for anybody to sit here, I can't deal with that. That is just ridiculous. That's preposterous. That's unbelievable, unethical, unacceptable, and unbelievable. Like, I had to break out the 4 ums for this, and I know my brother was sitting here just cracking up because I brought it back with that. Okay, yes, I brought it back to our old shit, because it just baffles me how they go after the working men and working women doing the 9-to-5s, you know, some of us doing 2-3 jobs and stuff like that, you know, to try and make ends meet for our families, you know, and you want to sit here and come at us like we're doing something wrong or we're something so minor, but yet you have people out there committing crimes every day, you know, and I don't see you going after them. I don't see anybody investigating my friend's case. I don't see nobody investigating my case. And it's just like, what is this fakakta nonsense? Fakakta nonsense, America. What is the deal with this? Because it's just crazy. You know, you got third world countries wanting to sit in here and come at us because they're upset of how we do things, because we went over there because we were upset how they did things. Like, hello, can we focus on the people here? Can we really focus on the people here? You know, and it's because of us as to why things are running. Don't you get it? Yes, corporate America may run things, but when it comes to the workers and all that stuff, we're the ones that turn around and bust our ass, do what we gotta do. And for us to get royally screwed like that, that's just not fair. And I know a lot of you guys out there, you guys do work hard and you do what you're supposed to. You're not being a gold digger, you're not being a whore, you're not being a slut. You know, you're out there doing what you have to do to provide for yourself and for your family. And I'm pretty sure that a lot of us have had a lot of hardships, especially being in the middle class. Now, if we were all upperclassmen making well over $100,000 a year and stuff like that, those wouldn't even be problems. You know, for all of us that work from, and they make a year from at least, I want to say 12,000 a year, you know, to 75,000 a year. That's all middle class, you know, and that's what makes our economy go around. Like, and it's crazy. And we're the ones that get stuck and stiffed the most. And it's like, what is our tax dollars going towards if you guys are constantly screwing us? What is it going towards? I don't know. I mean, can somebody answer that question for me? Because I want to know why I'm getting bills about things that are so irrelevant that I didn't even do, that's already paid for and all this nonsense. I want to know why my friend got her car repossessed. Like, that's just unbelievable. Unforgivable. It's just madness. Just madness. Pure chaos. Pure madness. You know, but that's something I had to share with you guys because I know some of you out there definitely experienced some nonsense like that. And that's not cool. That is just not cool. That's why I got the song playing in the beginning saying, get up, stand up, get that Bob Marley going. Even though we're not, you know, doing the full 420 business because we don't do that. Mm-mm. Not anymore. But all right, America, you already know who it is. It's the kid Antonio B. sitting here checking with y'all, you know, letting y'all know what's going on, what's popping. You know what I mean? You already know. Hit me up on Facebook. Look me up. The Blaze Experience Show. You know, add me on there. You already got my Facebook. You already got my email. You got my Twitter, even though I don't know why I have one. But, all right, guys. I'm going to catch y'all on the flip side. All right, y'all. Deuces. Understandable, we got sort of an offense and I can't forget it. Life is a gift, nobody wreck it. 50 cent, I tell them to check it. If you check it deeply, you're gonna see. Now for them, I pose up like bad man, but them, I wanna be. Say them all up, fast up in the club. Them, I look for me, but them gone empty. No artillery, yo. Positive, negative, and them can't hold the stress. Life get dry for them, run up in a mess. When things pop off, them are the first to get back. Now them, all them know them can't hold the flex. Send them to check it. Take up badness and that no make it. And listen up a week or sort of in the office and like it, I forget it. Life is a gift, nobody wreck it. 50 cent, I tell them to check it. They say they ready, but I know for sure they not ready. Yo. Go against the grain, if I show you gon' get it. Wolf, hip pop, drop, get dead it. Flee the crime scene, I mean, I forget it. When real rude boys pop up, they don't want credit. If niggas know you did it, then police know you did it. Whenever drama come, a real soldier gon' set it. If it's beef, get it. Big money, bet it in your brain.